Okay, now in this problem, we're going to consider a conceptual kind of problem that involves phase equilibrium between a liquid and a vapor phase. And often these problems, it's useful to draw a diagram to think about what's happening. And we start out with a system that involves nitrogen and water, where we assume nitrogen has a negligible concentration in the water under typical conditions of room temperature and 1 atmosphere. And so we'll have nitrogen and water in the vapor phase up here, and water in the liquid phase initially. And then we add a third liquid component with very low vapor pressure. So our new illustration is shown to the right, where we now have another component that's in the liquid phase, but not in the vapor phase. And basically, in this question, we're asking what happens to the number of moles of water in the vapor phase? Do we get condensation? A net condensation effect, or a where the number of moles in the vapor phase decreases, or a net evaporation effect where it increases. And so this is going to be maintained at constant temperature in this problem. It's constant temperature and constant volume. Okay, and so one thing that we see is that's going to happen is that the volume of the vapor phase is going to go down. Right, so as we add the liquid, this non-volatile liquid, we're not told how much we add, but whatever we add will decrease, will have the effect of decreasing the volume of the vapor, unless we get evaporation of the water to counteract that. We actually aren't going to get condensation of the water, and that comes from the fugacity effect. So recall that the fugacity of the water under these very mild conditions of 300 Kelvin, where water has a low saturation pressure, the partial pressure of water will just be equal to its mole fraction times its saturation pressure. Right, so this is the fugacity of the vapor phase here on the left-hand side and the fugacity of the liquid phase, and they're equal at phase equilibrium. And initially, we have a water concentrate or a water mole fraction in the liquid phase that is 1, but we are decreasing that in this problem. And so that means at constant temperature, remember the saturation pressure of water is a function only, or of any compound is only a function of temperature, and temperature is constant. So that means that the partial pressure of water is going to go down. And this would even be under a constant volume condition, we would expect the partial pressure of water to go down. And so water will want to condense as a function of this because the partial pressure of water is going to need to decrease. And in fact, that effect will be magnified if we lose space in the vapor, right, that the volume occupied by the water is also going to be decreasing. And so therefore, since both the pressure and the volume decrease, and we can roughly use the ideal gas law, that PV is equal to nRT at these low pressure conditions for water, where these are, this for example, is the partial pressure of water. Since this term decreases and the volume decreases and temperature remains constant, then the number of moles of water in the vapor phase have to go down. And so because of that, we'll have a net condensation of water when we add this non-volatile component.